11. Jeez, in the old days, we'd have been going for just over an hour by now. And we've been going on till 2 in the morning. This is why I look tired. I'm trying to get that sorted out. Apparently adding truck simulator wasn't the best way of achieving that, but never mind. Right, so let's continue after this small freight train comes through. We should be a smooth run up to the Winton in that area. I noticed this the other day, actually. When I just load tested this one, see, sort of got to wonder. I mean, there's got to be a caption there, hasn't there? I tell you what, folks. Grab a screen. I need to put captions on the Facebook page or Twitter. Hey, it's Derek. The route isn't finalised, you can't upload scenarios for it at all. Can the author? No. No one can upload scenarios for an unfinished route, or an unfinalised route. You feared a cowcatcher on the car. Nice Moggy. Already. Yeah, there we go. See, the humans coming through. Wasn't this a default train on MSTS? No, the MSTS had the Dash 9. This is an ES44DC. They look very similar on the outside, but they are different trains. Have I got a harp key string sound? I've got no idea, Dave. I can't remember. Good night, Strat Shadow. Thanks for everything. BT50 says an easy way to tell between the ES series and the Dash 9s is look at the radiator. The ES has a larger radiator. There you go, folks. I know what you mean, Buttermister. It's these are impressive trains, they really are. take long for each YouTube to upload. Well, I have to go into each stream and cut out all of the bits that make up each scenario. Probably takes me about half an hour to do a stream, which gets me four, five, however many videos. They then take an hour or two sometimes to up for Twitch to upload to YouTube. And once a video is up on YouTube, it probably then takes me probably about 5 minutes to get each one ready to go out. So it doesn't take too long, to be honest. So once I finish tonight, I will get everything on Twitch pushed up to YouTube, and then get at least two set up ready to go for tomorrow. Depending on the time, I might do more. Once they're on YouTube, that's the easy bit. I can thumbnail them up, because I use a thing called TubeBuddy, which is a plugin for YouTube, essentially. It updates all of the website for YouTube, gives me functionality. And one of the things it does is it will it gives me an automatic thumbnail generator. So I can just use that to... it's not quite automatic, I still have to make the thumbnail, but it does a lot of the work for me, which is such a time saver. Good night, Bushy. What program makes those thumbnails? It's called TubeBuddy. It's a website pop up on our. You have to sign up for it. It's paid. It's not a program. It's when you've signed up for it, you get a plugin for Chrome. And then you log that in. Once you've logged into your YouTube page, it puts a thing at the top of the page. YouTube, you click that and then it links TubeBuddy with YouTube. You get loads of extra stats, keyword assistance, SEO stuff, you get the key generator, thumbnail generator, you get all sorts of things. What time do I get to sleep? I normally try and be in bed by midnight. Cheers, Jeff. Gonna sign up for TubeBuddy, let me give you my referrer URL. There you go, posted the link up. This is a nice route, I do like Stephen's Pass. Look at our instructions, what we're doing anyway. Go via there, go via there, go via there. So once you get to Winton, we then got loading. Oh, I see, we're going to get a couple of wagons, load them, and then stop a little bit further up there. Interesting. A bit different. Oh, I'm glad you're enjoying the videos, Ben. Not a road, is it? It's a bridge. Just make sure everybody going underneath the railroad knows I'm coming. Fast with good cinematics, unfortunately. But we can try. Yeah, two of the scenarios, no, they're gone. That means I didn't get them uploaded to, I didn't get them clipped. If scenarios don't get clipped, then YouTube deletes them after a relatively short time, actually, about 10, 12 days. About someone making a scenario based around the Grand Canyon Railway. Do you mean a route? Because there is no route featuring the Grand Canyon, yeah? I don't really know much about the Grand Canyon Railway, except you don't really get much of a view of the Grand Canyon from what I remember. Good night, Butter Mister. Vision. You're an idiot! There we go, more humour between engineer and dispatch. Legionnaires. We'll have to look it up again, eh, Ruben? I don't want to look before, it just looks like it comes into it and then goes away from it. I can't really do movie star camera action when we're doing 43. Hey, Legionnaires, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Now, you can only really get the proper camera style action when you're doing about 20 to 25 or less. Back up for the climb. Anthony, you sent a tip over an hour ago and you haven't seen it yet. Oh dear, let me have a look. First off, thank you very much. Let me have a look on Twitch alerts. Yeah, it's not come through. Hopefully it'll come through later on. Thank you very much, Anthony R115, for the tip, really appreciate it. They normally come through pretty instantly, I don't know what's going on. If it doesn't come through by the end of the stream, remind me in the next stream, and then I can go and find it and think it properly. They have an option for letting you have to revalidate everything, and I've switched that off. It's come through on PayPal. Donations come through on PayPal, Anthony, so I don't know why it's not showing up on Team Twitch alerts yet. What is going on with this signal? That's wrong. Couple of them out. No, I've switched off the approval. Oh, I say, Anthony Riley, you've done with it in the e-check. So that it reckons that will approve on by the 21st of June. That's possibly why it hasn't gone through. No, I've switched off that thing, couple of them out, so that other currencies I don't have to manually approve anymore. Because that was just a pain. I don't know what's going on with that. I'm just going to go. Thank you in advance, Anthony. It'll that will come through, and I really appreciate it. When you want to watch Unstoppable, Netflix is your friend. Netflix, Unstoppable is on Netflix. Well worth the watch, it is too. As long as you check in and picking at the door. Up ahead, there's a crew that needs us to grab and load a few wood chip poppers and take them with us up to Merid. There's been some kind of spill up there and they need something to soak up the mess. I guess one of the loaders is broken down, plus we are the best option to get these wood chips to them ASAP. Away, train man. Is this high priority train, Lord BT-50? I didn't realise this was a high priority train. Okay, just clear the switch, reverse and grab the two empty hoppers sitting on Winton number 3. Load them in Winton number 1 and watch the crew working on the other loader. Tanks. Right, so we need to go to there. Train's going past that switch. Just that. So a conductor leaps out, runs all the way up down the track, and then stops for a breath. Did I have MSTS, Trainman 42? Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I had MSTS since 2 weeks before it was launched in the UK. run UK train sim as well, train man. Your best bet is to go to the UK Train Sim Forum, Train Man. I know it works, but one of the things you need to do is set the do something with the permissions to make it work properly. I know people have got MSTS working on Win 10. I must admit, I've got Open Rails on this machine. I've put a couple of MSTS add-ons inside Open Rails to look at, and that works very well on Windows 10 actually. Wagons are on the tilt. Stevens Pass is Washington, it's sort of Seattle, Washington, and that sort of area. And it sort of heads east from there. Look at the map. So that's north to Vancouver, is it? South, heading down the west coast, and then this is it heading east to, he looks up to see where it goes to, Apple Yard. There you go. Right, so focusing on what we're doing, however, I need to go and get those. Ooh, tea, Dave. Don't mind if I do. Blind Scotsman, I can't talk about what Dovetail might or might not be doing, I'm afraid. Right, conductor runs around the track as fast as he possibly can. Yeah, those freight cars are on the tilt railroad. I don't know quite what's wrong with them, but... See the Fred blinking away? Flashing away, I guess. Otherwise it'd be a bread. Andy T53, what's my job title? I'm senior producer on the new on the next gen train simulator. So I'm basically overseeing all the stuff going on with the new simulator and looking after all the teams that are doing all their bits. So technically, I'm part of the dev team. But I'm not actually doing dev. I've got much more talented people than I doing the dev. Right, we are now going to go and do the loading. So let's just sit on the back wagon. Go to this road here. Switch. Get us into the right road. Let's hop back on the back again. Fireworks be added in train simettons? They certainly can. If you've got Pacific Surfliner or Horseshoe Curve, the final career scenario that comes with both of them has fireworks in it. They look really good, actually. Right, let's get these two loaded up. Jump off. He's up back. Super Mr. MC, welcome to the stream. Wood chips, got proper mouth, wood chips. Custard powder. Thank you. X control back on the. I don't hold the thing. They won't be empty, they'll just be slightly less full. And there might be a little bit of mess all over the side of the track, all the way. Nice, now head to Winton Passing Siding W. Stop there while the guys prep the spill area up ahead in Merritt. Not sure what happened yet. Find out in part 4. Insert dramatic music here. Dun dun dun! There you go. That's my. Have you ever considered doing longer scenarios just for YouTube? Actually, YouTube are even less tolerant of longer scenarios. You ideally want to be about 10 minutes for a YouTube video. What I have been thinking about doing is recording a scenario offline and then cutting it, clipping it so it's just lots of nice camera angles and then to, you know, so that it's like the whole scenario in 10 minutes. Whereas the nice thing I like about these is you see the entire playthrough. So it's like a walkthrough essentially. Whereas the other ones will be just 10 minutes of you know, watching trains. US Farm Cop, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Stopping up ahead, 1.2 miles. Movie star camera action. We could do that actually. Just about at this speed. Have you ever been inside an American EMD loco? I can say that I have never been inside an American loco, and in fact I've only ever seen in person at the most half a dozen. That was when I went to Knoxville to see my father-in-law. Hey Don's 007, I'm unfortunately I can't talk about Dovetail stuff, I'm afraid. If you've got questions about things that are out, then I can answer them. How to, so forth. But if it's when is, why did, that sort of thing, then I can't answer that, I'm afraid. There's winter passing siding. Hey Ruben, missed a stop on Miami Westbound Beach because you replied from the chat. Ah, blame chat. Thanks, Dave. Right, let's focus on what we're doing. We're stopping here. Nice bump up. AA8 Harry 1, welcome to the stream. Funky Blood, what's the point of this ball game? This game is about driving trains. We don't have anything planned at the moment on Thursday, Ben, although I will be doing a Twitch Plays train sim on Thursday or Friday, and we'll see. We will be doing a Twitch Plays train sim this week. Train banter, there's the other purpose for the stream. Good run, see you in Leaving Wenatchee Part 4 coming soon. There's about 8 parts there now. I think he's uploaded another one. I think it's one of those. It's 7 parts now. Right then, folks, that's the end of the stream. Thanks very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed.